With Alicia Laya with Scott Leroy Marketing, and today we are going over our website overview class. So we are going to be going over the new website platform. For this class, we are going to start with the basics and go over how to customize some of the default information that's being loaded onto your new KW websites. So to start, you do want to log into your command platform. So that's going to be agent.kw.com. If you have any trouble logging in, always keep in mind that your username is not case sensitive, however, your password is. So if you do have any trouble signing in, you can always click on the little eyeball icon on the password box to see your password typed in there. So before we dive into our command end of things, I have a couple other tabs open that I'm going to go over with you guys. So the first tab I have open here is going to be our Scott Leroy Marketing website. So that's going to just be scottleroymarketing.com. So on our website, we have a section under agent resources here. And we have a page for the new KW agent websites. So I'm going to go ahead and click into here. And I will drop a link to this page directly in the chat box here for you. If you have any trouble accessing this page and it prompts you for a login, you will simply enter your market center number to log into our website. So on this page, we have a lot of basic information revolving around the new KW websites. So there is a lot of good resources here if you ever need to reference it. So the first thing we have on our page here is going to be our live training calendar. So if you ever need to access that, you can find that here. Or you can also access that under agent resources and training here. So that can always be found on our website. You can also add our training calendar to your Google Calendar by clicking this little Google Calendar button in the bottom right corner of the calendar. Going down below that, we have a link to our YouTube playlist. This playlist is going to be solely based on the new websites, so you can find all of our website videos here. And then down below that, we have some of those helpful tip videos linked here for you for easy access. So if you have not yet launched your new website and you are still using the old KW websites, we do have a section on here that goes over what to do before you launch your new site. And then down below that, we have some helpful tip videos on what to do after you have launched your new website. So we have this, how to update your command site, as well as some additional tip videos once you've upgraded that. And then down below that, we have some helpful links to these KWRI provided articles. So KWRI puts out many articles on any new updates going on. So they have a whole stream of articles based around the new KW sites. So you can find a few helpful ones linked here on our site. And you can also find those right on KW Answers. So that's going to bring us to this other tab that I have open up here. So this is going to be all of the KW articles that are based around the websites here. So they have an article for every aspect of the site that is available at this time. You'll see there is a long list of articles available here. And I will drop a link to this in the chat box for you as well. So if you want to grab those links and bookmark them for future reference, you can go ahead and grab those and save them. So now that we have gone over those couple sites here, I'm going to go ahead and close these out. And we're going to go back into our command here. So with the new sites, so if you have been with KW for a while, you may remember that on the old KW websites, any content added to the website or any adjustments such as your headshot photo, your name, your contact information, All of that had to be updated manually on the website. With the new KW sites that recently launched, this now updates automatically based on the information on your marketing profile. So, because of this, you do want to be sure that your marketing profile is always current and up to date and good standing, as this is the information that's going to feed over to your site as far as your contact information, your personal details, your bio. Everything in your marketing profile is going to feed over to your website. So we're going to go ahead and jump into our marketing profile and go over how to update that information. So to get to our marketing profile, we want to go to the top right corner of Command and click on our name here. And we're going to go down to Settings. Once our settings page loads, we want to go to the left side of the page and go under Connect Settings. And then that is where we can find our marketing profile. So the first thing that I will point out here is in our marketing profile, in the top right of the page, you're going to see this green toggle. So you want to make sure this is always toggled on, as this is what feeds your information to your website as well as your other marketing materials in Command. So if this was to be turned off, that means that your website will no longer be branded to you and your marketing materials will not have your marketing information on them. So always make sure this profile is toggled on at all times. Next, we have our headshot photo. You do want to be sure that your headshot photo is cropped down to a perfect square. If it looks distorted in the circle here, that is how it's going to show up on your marketing. If you do have any trouble cropping or resizing your photo, you can always send it over to us and we would be happy to help you get that adjusted for you. Next below that is going to be the team logo. So if you're on a team, you can add your team logo here, or if you have your own custom logo that you want to use for your marketing. If you don't have a custom logo or a team logo, we do recommend adding something here as a placeholder, whether it be a KW logo like you see here, or maybe a realtor designation logo. That's kind of personal preference there. The reason we recommend having something there as a placeholder is some of your marketing materials will automatically pull that image in. So if you don't have something uploaded there, it can show up as a broken image link on your marketing. So next under that is going to be your details. We do recommend being sure that your name reflects the same as it does on your license, just to make sure you are following compliance. And then you have your license number. You have a spot for your team name if you're on a team. You can add in a professional job title. If you have a custom slogan that you use for your business, and then your designations and credentials. Most likely for your designations box, you are going to see Realtor here. And if you're not sure how to get that little symbol there at the end, if you hold down the Alt key on your keyboard and then type in 0174, that's going to give you that little symbol there. Under that, you have the option to add in military affiliations. So if you are affiliated with the military, you can add that to your marketing profile. So your first drop down is going to be your affiliation type. And then you're going to get another drop down box to choose the branch that you are affiliated with. Once you select those, make sure that you click on this add button all the way to the right. Otherwise, those will not save into your profile. You do have to hit that add button for those changes to save. Under that is going to be your bio. So the way your bio looks in this box of your marketing profile is how it's going to show up on your website and your marketing. So if you have line breaks in between your paragraphs, like you see here, or anything like that, this is where you want to make sure that is reflecting the way you want it to look. Under the bio is going to be your contact information. So you'll have your mobile phone number, your office phone number. You have the option to add a fax number if you would like to. And then you have your email. So this can be your KW email, or if you have a non-KW email that you utilize for your business, you can change that. And then next to that is going to be your website URL. So most likely this is going to be your KW website domain, unless you are using a custom domain for your website and you would like to use that on your marketing instead. Next under that is going to be your market center information. We do recommend being sure this is always current and up to date. So if by chance you've transferred market centers or your market center has moved locations, always make sure this is reflecting the correct information just to be sure that you are within compliance. For the market center logo, unlike the headshot photo, even though it shows up distorted here in this circle, it will correct itself on your marketing, so you don't need to worry about resizing or adjusting that at all. Under the market center information is going to be your compliance items. So if there is any compliance text that your market center requires for your legal footer, you can add legal footer text here. You do not need to add in each office is independently owned and operated, as that is automatically reflected on your marketing. So if you were to type that into this box, it may show up on your marketing twice. Below that, you have the option to add legal footer links. So some offices do have links that are required for compliance. For example, Texas agents need to have their commission information forms uploaded. And New York agents need to have their standard operating procedure forms. So to add those, you can simply click on the Add Link button here. And then you're going to enter the link title and then the URL to that link. And then if you ever need to delete these, you can just simply click on the red trash can icon all the way to the right here. Under that is legal footer images. These are very small thumbnail size images. You'll see in the description that they are 128 by 48 pixels, so they are not very big. You probably don't want to use this for any major advertising or anything like that. However, you could maybe add in any additional credential logos or maybe vendor logos, but they are very small. Just keep that in mind. Next, under that is going to be your social media links. So if you have your social media business pages set up, you can add those links here for those to be added to your website. So you can add in your Facebook page, if you have a Twitter account, your Instagram, if you have a YouTube channel, as well as your LinkedIn profile. So all of those are options to add to your marketing there. And then at the bottom, we have a section for Google Analytics ID. This has moved to the back end of the website. So once we dive into the site, I will show you later on in this class where to add that in to the back end of the website. However, you can also add that to your marketing profile here. So your Google Analytics ID is going to be used to track the traffic information to your website. So if you need any assistance setting that up, you can always reach out to us and we can help you in getting your analytics set up for you. So now that we've covered our marketing profile here, always make sure that you click on save anytime you make any updates here. That's going to refresh the page for you, and it's going to let you know that your marketing profile was saved. So now we can go ahead and jump into our consumer tab, which is going to be where our website is. So that's going to be the last icon on the left side menu here. If you're still getting familiar with what each of these icons stand for, you can click on the KW logo in the top left corner up here, and that will bring out a description of each of these icons until you get familiar with them. So we're going to go ahead and jump into consumer. So now that we are in our consumer tab, a couple of things that I will go over, as I know this looks a bit different from the original site if you were here before the new websites launched. So The difference on this page here is instead of having our site and app settings link that used to be in the top right corner, everything is now built into this page here. So down below here, we have our website domain. So if you ever need to change or update your domain name, you can do that here. Under that is going to be your app URL. So if you ever need to locate the URL for your mobile app, you can come in here and copy that. Down below that is going to be our preferences. So these are the same as they were previously. So if you want to show or disable the color covered information from your KW consumer app, this is where you can do that here. And then below that is going to be your first registration options. So this is going to require your clients to sign up with a consumer login on your site based on the settings that you choose here. And this will also capture their contact information as a new lead within your command database. So you have the option to leave it as unrestricted, meaning that clients can view unlimited properties without having to register on your site. You can set it to a maximum of 10 properties, a maximum of 2 properties, or you can set it to no property viewing, which means they will not be able to view any listing properties until they are registered. So those are your options there for the forced registration. If you make any changes to this page, always be sure you click on the Save Changes button for the section that you are updating, as you'll see each section has its own save button here. So just make sure you're selecting the correct save button for the section that you are updating. Keep in mind also that any changes you make within this page or within your marketing profile do tend to take about 15 to 30 minutes to reflect on your live site. So if you do make any updates and you don't see that reflecting right away, it may just need some additional time to sync over. The other thing that I will mention before we jump into our website is you may notice at the top of the page here that we no longer have an option for landing pages. This is completely intentional as they have now moved this into the back end of the website dashboard. So now we're going to go ahead and jump into our website dashboard. So we're going to get to that by clicking on the Edit My Website button here in the center of the page. So we'll go ahead and click on that. And that's going to open a new tab for us, which is going to be the dashboard of our website here. When you first get into this, you may see a pop-up for a tour like this here. So you can take the tour or you can select Explore My Own to access the website right away. You can always revert back to that tour if you ever need to by clicking that tour button in the top right corner here. So as for today's class, we will kind of work our way down the Edit My Website portion right here. So as far as the overall platform, these may not be in order, but we will start from the top and go down just to avoid too much confusion here. All of the pages listed here are the default pages for every newly launched site. There is not currently an option to rearrange these on this list. However, you can click into them and edit them in whatever order you prefer. So at the top of this list here, we have the blog list page. So that is where your blog is going to be on your website. Then we have our About the Agent page. So this is going to be our profile information from our marketing profile. And then we have our home page, which is going to be our hero images, our IDX search, our featured listings, as well as featured testimonials and a blog section. So we'll go ahead and get started by jumping into the first page here, which is the blog list page. So this is where all of your blogs are going to be held if you have any blogs added to your website. Every newly launched site is automatically provided with a four-part buyer's guide blog, So you should be seeing that on your website already. And then any additional blogs will need to be added manually by each agent. So you do have the option to create your own custom blogs for your website, or you can just stick with those first default generic blogs there. For the blog list page, you have the option to have up to 10 blogs on your site at a time. So you'll see you can have between 1 to 10. So you can add additional blogs by going into here and clicking on the little plus symbol here. And that's going to give an open line here. So if we click on this little text box here, that's going to bring up a pop-up box here to select the blog that we want to add. So if we have already created our blog post, we would be able to find that here in this pop-up. And we can search by going under type and looking for the blog post type. If you have not created your blog post yet and you're looking to create a new blog post, you can simply click on the new button in the bottom left corner of this pop-up box, and that will take you to a form to build your custom blog. If you want to rearrange the blogs on your site, you can do that by clicking the arrow with the three lines here and simply clicking and dragging those around here. If you need to remove any blogs from your site, so you'll see we have a part one blog on here twice. So we can remove that by clicking the red line here next to the blog, and that will remove it from our page for us. Once you finish making any changes to your page, always be sure that you click on the save button in the top right corner to make sure that your change is saved there. You do also have the option here to change the title and description if you would like to. So the default title is going to be the Take It From Our Experts. However, you can customize that by simply typing in that title box there. And then the description is going to be the text that shows up under the title right above your blogs there. So those are completely customizable if you have your own verbiage that you want to use for those. So once you save your page, you're going to see this green banner at the top letting you know that it was saved. And then you're going to have a link to take you back to your website dashboard there. So we'll go ahead and click on that. You can also always go back to your dashboard at any time by clicking on the KW logo in the top left here. This is always going to take you back to your dashboard page. So next is going to be the About the Agent page here. So we'll go ahead and click into this one. So this is going to be your About Me page. So if you did have the old legacy websites, you may remember the About Me page on the old sites. So the difference here is those are no longer editable through here. This is automatically pulling your information right from your marketing profile. So that is why it's very important to always make sure your marketing profile is always up to date at all times if you ever have any updates to make. So there is a drop down for each of these sections here. However, you'll see if we click into these, there is no options to edit the information. The only options we have here is to either display or hide the section from our page. So if we wanted to hide our agent profile, we can change that to hide. And that's going to hide our profile information at the top there. However, you'll see it does keep our details and our bio because those are separate sections here. So you can choose what you want to show or hide if you only want to show certain aspects of your profile. That's completely customizable there. The last drop down here is preferred vendors. So you now have the option to add preferred vendors to your site. So, if we click on this drop down here, this is provided to us through a third-party platform called MoveEasy. So there is a link here. So it says click this link. So if we click on the Word link, that's going to take us to the vendor page. So this is where we can add and remove our vendors from our preferred vendor section. So to add a new preferred vendor to your site, you can go to the top right and click on this Add Vendor button here. And that's going to give you a form to add your vendor. So you're going to have your vendor name, the vendor URL if you have their direct website, their contact name, and email if you have a certain point of contact, the telephone number, and then the vendor type. You'll see there is a full drop-down list here, or you can simply type in this search box here to find what you're looking for. You also have the option to add in the counties that the vendor services, and you can also add in the vendor logo. So those are all your options for your vendor form here. You'll see the only options that are required are the vendor name and telephone number. However, of course, the more information you have for the vendor, the better. And then once you fill this form out, you can simply click on the Add Vendor button at the bottom, and that will add them to your vendor list. So if we go back to our site here, I'm going to scroll down here. So this is where those vendors are going to show up. So if you add in their logo, the logo is going to show up here in the box. And then there will be a link for their website, as well as a link for more information where they can fill out a contact form to reach out to you. And that will also capture them as a lead in your database. So once again, with our About the Agent page, if we make any changes here, always be sure that you click on the Save button in the top right corner to save your changes. And then we can go ahead and go back to our dashboard. So next is going to be our homepage here. So we're going to go ahead and click into our homepage. So you may see this yellow banner at the top here. So if you make any changes to your page and you forget to save it, or your browser closes out on you, or maybe you lose internet, this is always going to save your progress until you either click that save button or you clear changes. So if you ever accidentally close out, you don't have to worry about losing the work that you were doing, as it will keep those saved in here until you come back to the page. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Clear Changes here just to clear this out for us. There we go. So we'll start with the first section here and just work our way through our homepage here. So our first section is going to be our search module. So this is going to be our title, which is the text above the search box here. So that is completely customizable if you have different verbiage you would prefer to use for your site. And then you have your hero images. So you're always going to have these default images provided by KW, or you also have the option to add in your own custom images. If you add your custom images, these default images go inactive. However, you will still see them in this dropdown, because if you were to ever remove your custom images, it will then reactivate these. That way, you always have some kind of image running and it's not just blank there. To add a custom image, you can either click on the Upload File button to upload your image from your computer, or if you already uploaded your images, you can click on the Add Image button and you can find those in here. You can add multiple images and it will pretty much work as a slideshow through each of the images that you've added here. You can also reorder them by clicking and dragging if you want them to show up in a different order. So that's completely customizable there. And then you can remove them by clicking the red line there. So next up is going to be our featured listing section. So our featured listings are going to appear right under that search section there. So for your featured listings, you can change the title if you would like to. So if you want that to say something else, you can customize the title text. And you can also enter your own description if you want a different description there. So this automatically defaults to featured listings and then check out my featured properties. So if you want that to say something else, you can adjust those here. Scrolling further down here. So the first thing that you want to do for your featured listings is make sure that the correct location is entered for the center point location. So this is going to be the center point from where your featured listings are going to pull from. You can use a full street address, or you can just use a city and state or zip code, whatever works best for you. And then that's going to kind of radiate out in a circle based on the search radius that you enter here. So you can choose the maximum number of listings that you want to display. We do recommend not putting too many on here, as most people are not going to sit here and scroll through an entire list. However, that's completely up to you how many you would like to have on your page here. And then your search radius. So just keep in mind, the bigger the search radius is, the further away the listings are going to get. So if you only want to show listings that are close by, just make sure that search radius here is reflecting that. You can have these sorted by living area, by price range, by the days that the listing has been active, as well as recently updated. So you have many different options for sorting those here on your site. And then you can also manually add listings to your featured listings. So if you have your own personal listings that you want to be sure are showing up on your featured listings, you can add those manually by clicking the plus symbol here and entering the property address here. Or you can also search by the MLS ID number, and that will pull the listing up for you as well. When you add your listings manually here, these are going to show up very first on the list. So those will always be the first ones that are seen under your featured listing section. And you can also click and drag to reorder these if you have multiple listings and you want them to show up in a certain order there. And then to remove them from your site, you can simply click on the red dash here. Under that, we have another drop down here for filters. So if we click on this filter drop down, you can set additional criteria for your featured listings. So you have listing categories, so you can select more than one. So you have the option for sale, sold, rent, as well as listing status. You have active, pending, and coming soon. Now, keep in mind for these, this is also going to be based on what your local MLS allows. Not all MLS boards allow the option to show coming soon or pending listings. So those will not show up under your featured listings if it's not allowed by your local MLS, as all of this pulls right from the MLS platform. And then you have the option to select your property types. So if you only want to show houses or if you only want to show land, whatever you specialize in, you can pick and choose the types of properties that you want to pull into your featured listings. You can also select the range for bathrooms and bedrooms. You can select a range for home size, lot size, as well as a price range. So if you only want to show properties within a certain price range, you can enter that in here and set that criteria up. You also have the option to add keywords. So for instance, we have pool entered here, which means this is only going to pull in listings that have a pool. Or if you maybe want to show listings that have a garage, you can add garage as a keyword. And you can add multiple keywords at a time here. And you can also remove them by clicking that red dash. So that's going to be our featured listing section there. So I'm just going to scroll up and minimize this out of the way. So next we have our featured testimonial section. So for the featured testimonials, just like the featured listings, you can change the title and description if you would like to customize that at all. And then down below that, you can sort them by newest or oldest. And you can also manually sort them by clicking and dragging as well. So you have a couple different options there for sorting those out. And then you can show up to 20 testimonials on your site at a time. So for those of you who did use the old sites before the new sites launched, you may remember that you could only have a maximum of 12 testimonials on your site at a time. So now they have increased that with the new sites to show up to 20 at a time. So for your testimonials, if your testimonials have been captured on your website, you can locate those by coming in here and clicking on the plus symbol here. And you should be able to locate those in the drop-down list here to select to show on your website. Or if you are looking to add testimonials from another platform, such as maybe Zillow reviews or Google reviews, anything like that, you can manually add testimonials in here. So you can do that by clicking on the Create New button at the very top of this dropout menu. And that's going to open up a form here to add in the testimonial details. So for your testimonials, you need to select the star rating of your testimonial. Then you'll enter your testimonial text. Below that is going to be the client's name, so you will need their first and last name. And then the client sent date. And then you also have the option to add in a location here. However, the location is not required. So if you don't have that information, it's not too big of a deal there. And then there is a toggle here for recommended. So we do recommend having that toggled on. And then once you complete the form, just be sure to click on the publish button in the top right. And that way it will publish it to your testimonial list. And then we can click on the back link in the top left here. And then once you publish that, it should show up in this drop-down list here to choose for your site. So again, you can rearrange these by clicking and dragging them. And you can also remove them from your site by clicking the red dash there. You also have the option to hide any of these items from your homepage. So if you don't want your testimonials on your site, you can choose to hide this. And same with the featured listings as well. You do always have the option to hide that from your homepage as well. And then last at the bottom of our homepage is the blog section. So this is very similar to the blog list page that we first went over. So you can change the title and description here. And then just like the blog list page, you can come in here and reorder these, or you can remove them or add additional ones. The only difference here is on the homepage, it's pretty much a preview of your blog list page, so you can only view up to four at a time. Whereas on the actual blog list page, you can have up to 10 at a time. So if they come in here and they click on the Read More button, that's going to take them right to the blog list page to view the rest of your blogs if you have additional blogs. And just like the other ones, you do have the option to hide this from your homepage if you wish to not have that on there. So, like our other pages, if we make any changes here, always be sure to click on the Save button in the top right. The system also tracks any revisions that you make to your site on any of these pages. So you're going to see over here on the right side, we have a revisions list. So any change or update that's been made to the site is going to be listed here. So if you ever need to revert back to a previous version, or you want to go back and compare or edit it or anything like that, you do have the option to view those revisions here. So we're going to go ahead and go back to our dashboard. So the other thing we have here under our default sections here is going to be our default form, which is our contact form. So you'll see there is not a lot of customization we can do here. The only thing that we can change on the contact form is going to be the title, which is the text that shows up at the top of the form here. All of the contact details and information here on the left side of the form is pulling from the marketing profile. So if any of this information is incorrect, you just want to make sure you update that in your marketing profile. So if you do come in here and make any changes to the title, just be sure that you click on that Save button to save your changes. And then we can head back to the dashboard. So up at the top of your dashboard here, you do have a quick start section. So here is where you can create blog posts. If you want to create your blog posts before adding them to your site, you can create additional custom pages on your site. You can create standalone landing pages. And then you also have a couple templates here. We do have a website customization class, which we will be going over next Tuesday, that covers some of these aspects here. So if you need help with any of those, we do recommend jumping in next week to see how those work here. So the other thing on the site that I will go over today is for those of you who did use the old legacy websites, you may remember that you were able to create an open house sign-in landing page. So you still have the option for an open house sign-in sheet. However, that has now moved right into the websites, and I will show you how to generate those. So we're going to click on the link here at the top to open our live website up. So there's a couple different ways that you can get to your listing. So to generate your open house sign-in sheet, you first want to open up the listing that you are hosting the open house for. So you can either search for it in the property search box here, or if you have the listing added to your featured listings, you can click on it under your featured listings here. So I'm just going to click on one of these listings here. So this is going to pull in all of the details from the MLS listing. So we have all of our photos here. We have our MLS details down here. So to get our open house sign-in sheet, what we want to do is we want to open up the listing here, and then we're going to go up to the top of our browser and click on the search bar here. And we want to go to the very end of this URL and type in backslash open house, and then we're going to hit enter. And once that page loads here, it's going to repopulate to our open house sign-in page. So you're going to see that URL up at the top change to something new. So once that updates, you can copy and save this to either share it or make a QR code. Or if you just need it for personal reference, you can grab that and keep it somewhere. So what's neat about this is this open house sign-in sheet is completely revolving. So you can have this up during your open house on your laptop or tablet or whatever device that you prefer to use. And each of your clients can sign in with this one page. So they're going to enter their information here. So we have first name, last name, email address here, as well as phone number. And all of these items are required. And there's also going to be a checkbox here for this opt-in notice. This is just stating that they opt in to receive any phone calls, emails, text messages, any correspondence from you as the agent. And once that form is filled out and they hit the submit button, that's going to then give them a preview of your agent profile. And it's also going to give them a QR code to scan, which is going to pull up the MLS details for that listing. And that's going to keep the site completely branded to you as well. So once you finish capturing their information, you can click on the back to sign in button on the top left corner here. And that's going to completely refresh the form to capture the next client's information. So this form can be used for the entire duration of your open house. You can just keep it up for the entire time and capture all of those leads as they come in. As anyone that enters their information on this sheet is going to go into your command database as a new contact lead. So that's going to be our open house sign-in page here. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of these and go back to our dashboard. So the last thing that I will go over here is I kind of touched on during our marketing profile overview that the Google Analytics ID is on the back end of the website now. So to locate that, if we click on the three lines in the top left corner here, that's going to give us a menu and we want to go under admin and then organization site. And that's going to take us to the back end here. So if we scroll down a little bit, this is where we can find the section for Google Analytics ID. So this is where you want to put that tracking ID in to track that traffic information to your website. And just like all of the other pages, once you add that in, make sure that you click on that save button in the top right corner. So that about wraps us up for today. If you run into any trouble at all or have any questions, you can reach out to us anytime at support@scottleroymarketing.com. And we're happy to jump in and take a look and help out. Thank you for jumping on today, and I hope you all have a great rest of your week.